southern part of Texas, east and west of El Paso, where the mighty Franklin Mountains guard the trail to Mexico. There's a new made way to cry in the young bulls. An eagle as she glides somewhere beyond the great divide. He's heard the call of the wild. He's heard the call of the wild. The mountains call him to him like a mother calls her child. He's heard the call.
See the other one? Can you see the other one?
I can see him, I just can't get a shot.
Okay, just wait, just wait. Just get set up. Got two nice balls, both shooters. Lucas is gonna shoot the one on the left for us. As soon as he gets a shot. Hoping to get one with a bow, but the weather's coming in on us. Good shot. Beautiful. Brilliant. Brilliant, brilliant shot. No one doesn't know who we are yet. Oh, yeah. Good shooting. Good shot. Beautiful. Coast of New Zealand, and the cold wind. We've just come up and we've found Lucas's bull tahr. Tell us all about the day, Lucas.
Well, we started out first thing in the morning. We spotted a nice bull, and we came up this ridge, and we split off from our group. And as we started coming up the ridge, we were jumping tahr. Quite a few tahr, groups of 5 to 10 at a time. Continue to climb and get elevation. Probably roughly 4 to 5 hours of a climb we spent, and got up around 6,500 feet and started side hilling. And as we came down to the bottom of the crest of this ridge, I looked up and I saw two nice tahr, or what appeared to be two nice tahr. So I whistled and we stopped. We cut back around and we kind of looked at each other and agreed that the way the wind conditions were going and the clouds were potentially blowing in, that it was probably going to be a rifle. My full intention was to come out here and try to take one of these with my bow, as they said no one's done it, but they said it could be done. But right now I'm really happy with the take. It was about a 170-yard shot. Got rested up on a rock, Remington 700 270, one shot, center mass, high in the shoulder, and that was it.
Paul X'd him.
Rolled down and came up here, and can't believe the size of this animal. The cape on it is just amazing. This time of year, as you know, they start to grow this really, really dark and heavy cape to prepare for winter, and just a beautiful animal. Here in New Zealand, never thought I would make it here, and I'm here, and on an awesome hunt. I can't thank you guys enough, and River Safaris, Mark and Pam, and obviously my amazing my guide here, Pog, who got me into this beautiful tahr.
So, my pleasure.
Thank you very much. And I look forward to more hunting in the days to come.
Absolutely. Try and get a stag with that bow.
Yeah, we're going to stick something with the bow.
Definitely.
A couple more animals. But this was definitely the biggest challenge here for me.
Yeah.
And challenge well done, I think.
Would have been very nice to get him with the bow, but as you said, the conditions just weren't.
Yeah.
He was just up to the bows.
Yeah, we probably could have got within 60 yards, which is a fair shot, but you know, to let a bull like this slip by and potentially not have a shot at him with the bow, we decided to take him. So, good decision, ethical decision, and at the end of the day, it was the right decision. So, again, appreciate it. You guys have been excellent, and. Again, recommend this group and outfit to anyone who decides to come to New Zealand. It's very professional and great accommodations, and very fortunate to be here. So.
Thank you. Yeah, pleasure.
Thank you.
Well done, Lucas.
All right.